riding on the city of New Orleans. Illinois Central, Monday morning rails. 15 cars and 15 restless riders. 3 conductors and 24 sacks of mail. All along the southbound Odyssey, the train rolls out of Kankakee and moves along past houses, farms, and fields. Passing trains that have no name, and switch yards full of old black men, and graveyards full of rusted automobiles. Good morning, America, how are you? Say, don't you know me? I am your native son. I am a train they call the city of New Orleans. I'll be gone 500 miles when the day is done. Playing cards with an old man on the club car. Penny a point, nobody's keeping score.
Can be found in this cookbook, which you can't get anywhere. It's an old church cookbook. By the way, a great place to actually pick up some good recipes. But this recipe is more than a church cookbook. This was my grandfather's recipe. He's not with us anymore. In fact, I never met him. Died a few months before I came around. But he was a railroad guy for the Illinois Central, city of New Orleans, as they nicknamed it. And the railroad guys used to make this beef stew back in, I guess it would have been the 50s or so, if I'm guessing. But it's really, really good. And I have fun with it sometimes and add some different spices, sometimes making it a little more chili-like. But it's just really good. Whether you want it plain or spicy, you can do it either way. And top it with some sharp cheddar cheese, because that's what's really going to make it good. The best thing beside it is really not cornbread. It's the old plain saltine cracker. That is the best with this particular stew. And I will tell you this, it's got a great name. It's Homer Stew. He was Homer Brown, so it's Homer Stew. Enjoy it.
I was riding number 9, going south from Carolina. Left my home. I heard that long.